Hi, hi everyone, guys. Today we are going to see something about Krita. Nothing about workflow, nothing about the use of the program. I'd like to answer to a question you wrote in the comments. And the question was about the installation and the fix about some issues in the first part of using Krita. So we don't have to think about the workflow, checkpoint and so on, but we want to see how to install and use Stable Diffusion on Krita. How to do this? First thing you have to do is to install Krita, first of all. So you need Krita, and you have to go to krita.org. In my case is in Italian. I leave in the description the link, so you have just to follow the link. You see the first page with everything. Make a donation, because this program could be a very, very interesting and helpful program to use with a new point of view AI. So first of all, you have to download the Krita installer. In my case, I want to use the last one release, the 5.2.3, very recent, in June. So you have to I swap to English, so you can see in English. Download Krita Windows installer, and you have a simple installer, an X, nothing more, nothing less, like this. Okay, Krita, in my case x64. Okay, so after this you have to double click Krita, follow the instruction to install Krita as a program, as a simple program, like whatever you want, Photoshop or Affinity, whatever. So you had Krita installed, okay? And this could be your Krita. Now this is my homepage. I create a new image. Okay, so you have a Krita, but you have to install something else to use Stable Diffusion, because Krita doesn't have this feature. You have to install something with Krita, an add-on, a simple add-on, Python add-on. So you have to go in this repository on GitHub. I leave, of course, the link in the description. Don't worry, very easy. This is the file. This is the file krita_ai_diffusion. Okay, with everything you need to know, and so you have to click this link here. Very simple, and you will download this zip, Krita eDiffusion zip. Leave it where you download it. Leave it there. So why you have to leave it? Because you have to install this add-on through Krita. How to do this? Open your Krita, go to tools, okay, over there, scripts, import Python plugin from file, okay, click and click. In my case, I have already installed, so I don't want to reproduce this click. You will have a simple pop-up, something like activate plugin. Of course, you have to click yes, and it will install your plugin. And that's all. Nope. You have to, because now when you have installed your plugin, you have to restart Krita, close everything and reopen it, and you have to activate the AI Docker. This is quite different from any other program in graphics, so you have to follow these steps carefully, but it's very easy. Okay, you have to go to settings. Okay, you have to check show dockers. Okay, very important. And you have to go to dockers. As we can see, we have many dockers. I'm using just a few because I'm not proficient in this program right now. I'm working on it because the AI, so I'm very good with Photoshop, but with Krita I'm just learning. You have to check whatever docker you want, but the first one is our docker. You have to check AI image generation. Without this flag, nothing will happen. So remember setting after restart the program, after you have installed the plugin, you have to settings, show dockers, AI image generation. This will be very important. Now I already have installed everything, so you could have something like, now I want to close and reopen Krita just to show you something you might have, because in my case I'm working with Krita all day long, so it's very okay. Create a new image. Okay, you have something like this. Server is not installed or running, so you have just to click configure. In my case is up here. You could see something like this. Server is not installed or running. Click below to start. Just click configure. Very simple. Okay, right, we are here in Krita, and you will see something like this. Okay, now this I will we show you in a moment. Now you have to choose what kind of server management you want. In my case, because I have a 4060 Ti with 16 giga of RAM, I'm using local server managed by Krita. So everything is installed and stored in your PC, your machine, and will use your CUDA or your library for AMD. Okay. Just to be perfectly clear, I want to show you something very important. The specs for Krita, because you have to, now if I found it in a moment, I think right here. Now if you want to run locally your Krita and your Stable Diffusion, you have to see this requirement. In our case, you need at least a GTX 1060 with at least 6 giga of VRAM. But it's very, very, very painful. So more VRAM you have, better. It's better. So this kind of requirements follow the deficiency. with CUDA, with NVIDIA, you don't have problems in any way, okay? With a 40 or also a 3070 with 12 giga, 16 giga, or better, 24 giga with the 4019 or whatever, 90 whatever. But with NVIDIA, with CUDA, you don't have problem. So if you have an NVIDIA, it's fine, it's good. If you have an AMD, look at this. You need at least 12 giga. It's slow with limited feature set, okay? And you need something with Linux. So I don't know how it works with AMD. I see some Reddit with problems. So it's up if you have an AMD. Maybe you have to work with something else. Apple is just like Stable Diffusion. It's been in you know where. And with Krita you have to work with MPS. So if you have if you work with Apple, could be a problem. Same with CPU. Look, it's gray work, but it's very slow. So you need an NVIDIA AMD with a minimum 12 giga of VRAM. This is the requirement. So be sure to have something like this. So we have decided to a local server managed by Krita plugin. So you have to check this menu here, and you have to install everything. In my case, I install everything here. Run on CPU, nope. Use CUDA in my case, or if you want, use the DirectML, but in my case it's NVIDIA. I have NVIDIA, so okay. And after this you will have this menu completely empty. You have just to check everything, check Python, check checkpoint, workload, check, upscaler in my case, check, and install. I have stop, but you have install because I have installed everything. So install everything, shut down Krita, and you could start with everything. As you can see, I install also the ControlNet extension, Scribble and Arsoft Edge, Canny, Depo, Cementation, and the Excel. This is how to install Krita. That's all, folk. Now, when you start Krita, remember to go to settings and Dockers, i.e. AI image narration, to see this Docker here. I don't know where it is. Maybe it's here, or I don't know. Okay, it's over here, or just in another window here. I'm fine with this kind of work. So when you have installed everything, you should see this AI image generation, and here we have everything we need: checkpoint, LoRa, style, negative prompt, Vi, sampler, like Stable Diffusion. So you have to, this is diffusion, not important. See, this could be important if you want. This is the batch size, how many images you want to create every iteration. Okay, this could be and should be automatic. So I find my 4060 Ti, and that's all. You could start working with Krita. Choose your checkpoint. Ah, okay. Something important. We install. By default, you can install through Krita Realistic Vision Dream Shaper Juggernaut XL. Okay, by default. And our checkpoint, very interesting. Blah 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 blah. If you want to use your checkpoint or other checkpoint through taken by you know Civitai or whatever, you could use your checkpoint. How? Style. Model checkpoint. Here there is a open the folder where checkpoints are stored. So you have your your folder in Krita. So you have to put your checkpoint here. And the same things the same thing about Laura. Click Laura. Okay. So you can add your checkpoint or your Laura here. Remember to refresh every time you add something. Okay? And now, as always, you can generate. So you prompt something and generate an image. You can upscale what you want, or you can go live with the strength of our AI, the seed, if you want, and everything about control net. Click, 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 control net, blah, 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 blah. Okay, this is how to install and start with Krita. Very simple, very easy. Hope you like it. Hope this video could help you in your journey with AI, with Krita. I know that this program will become a very very important step in knowing AI and in working with AI, because it's very intuitive, because it's very friendly in the way it works with AI, and powerful. The best, I don't know, because every single work, every single job, any single task you want to manage with AI, it's different. So you could use Midjourney and it will fine, will be awesome. You could use Stable Diffusion XL, Flux if you want, or Krita. Different program for different task, for different objective. So today I just want to show you how to manage Krita and the installation, and I think I will take some vacation at the end of August. So see you in September, I hope, with new video. I think new interesting feature about Krita and about Flux, I think, and everything you need to be updated with AI. So thank you, and as always, ciao ciao ciao.